Stick around because in this video, I'm going to explain four foods that I implement almost daily to help me crush my weight loss goals. I first want to start off by thanking the sponsors of this video, Male Ultra Core Supplements. They reached out to me about 2 months ago because they noticed my journey and they noticed that I was having a little bit of a lull with my weight loss. And this is a natural testosterone boosting complex, all natural, so no crazy drugs or anything like that on this channel, at least. That's how I'm gonna do my journey, you do you. But I'll tell you what, when you end up boosting your testosterone, you really help boost your weight loss journey. And I could tell right away because I was having the lull in the weight loss and then it became more consistent. I'm gonna drop a link below so you can check it out for yourself. This is absolutely a quality product and I highly recommend it. If you're getting close to your goal or even if you're in your weight loss journey in the trenches and you need some kind of a boost and you want to start building muscle as well. I've noticed so much vascularity coming towards me and it's absolutely incredible. Go ahead and check them out. They'll be in the link below. Hi guys, it's Dad Bod to Bad Dad and welcome back to my channel. If you don't know who the heck Dad Bod to Bad Dad is, well, I'm a dad and I'm on a 110-pound weight loss journey. Since starting my new job, I have kind of been lacking on updating you on the last 2 weeks of weight loss, so let's see what I've done in the last couple of weeks. 5.2 pounds. Hit the subscribe button and ring that notification bell so you never miss a video. Now let's get into this video in which I talk about my four favorite foods that I implement almost daily to help me lose weight and crush my weight loss goals. A lot of you have been reaching out to me in the comment section. I appreciate it. You want to know what I eat in a day. Now, next week, I will be releasing the first video in that series of an Eat With Me, but today I just want to get you kind of the basics of what I like to eat as far as my main food groups go. The first food group I eat almost daily is avocado. It's full of potassium, which helps you recover for workouts and keeps you more consistent. It is kind of fatty, but it is also high in fiber, which helps with digestion. And I find it a good replacement for those creamy sauces that I used to use, because if you can cream it up, you can put it on a sandwich, you can put it on a salad, and you can end up using less dressing. So I'm using avocado as a tool, although a lot of people find it fattening. It is absolutely incredible. My hair, my skin, it just makes everything a lot more supple and growth. Plus, I love the taste of avocado. Now, also, another thing I want to highlight about avocado is it decreases inflammation. So all the inflamed muscles and tendons you get from breaking them down and working out in the gym helps recover way faster as well. And that potassium also helps you recover, as I had mentioned before. So eat avocados daily. I eat a whole avocado or even more. My next food that I eat almost daily is spinach. You want to eat spinach, it keeps you full, it's high in fiber, it helps you stay regular, not to be too descriptive. It actually helps you absorb foods better because it's high in fiber as well, and it's high in water content. So it just helps the digestion, helps keep everything flowing, and that is a good tool to use during your weight loss. Spinach also boosts immunity. When you're working out and you want to stay on this weight loss journey, you want to stay healthy as possible because you want to be able to get to the gym every day. You want to be able to get to work. You want to be keeping moving. You don't want to be having any downtime. You want to hit the ground running and keep that ball rolling until this big snowball just keeps growing and growing and growing, and you've had huge success. I've lost 97 pounds in the last 5 months, and where a lot of people mess up is they lose it fast like that, they usually end up getting sick. But since I do implement foods like spinach, I've never gotten sick during this whole 5 month, 97 pound weight loss journey. Another thing that I get a lot of questions about is my loose skin. And so far, I'm at 97 pounds loss, as I just said. I don't have much loose skin, not much loose skin at all. And one of the reasons I believe is because spinach boosts collagen production and reproduction. And I feel like, I don't know guys, I mean, I didn't buy into it before, but the results show for themselves. Eat these healthy foods, like spinach, help to boost collagen. And I don't know, drink a lot of water and just put good things in your body. You definitely want to set yourself up for success. And if spinach happens to do that, put it in your body every day. Now, I don't have red meat on this list because it is a highly inflammatory food. I absolutely adore red meat. Before I started my weight loss journey, that was my main meat source. Now I've switched to chicken. Chicken is so versatile. It's very filling. It pairs well with avocado and spinach. I think I see you know where this is going. Maybe a little spinach avocado chicken salad. I don't know. Maybe that'll be in the next video. Definitely check it out. If you are eating red meat a lot like I used to and you're getting inflamed and sore and everything like that, start switching to the lighter meats like chicken. And I know that seems pretty basic, but some people don't know, and that's why I wanted to put chicken in this video. Probably the most controversial food on this list, which is bananas. People say, oh, they're highly fattening. They're also full of potassium and fiber, much like the avocado. Not quite as much potassium as the avocado. I'm not gonna say avocado is a better fruit or banana is a better fruit. I happen to think avocado leans towards the better, more nutritious fruit, but avocado's not for everybody. Bananas, however, are a great snack to pick up when you're just on the go and you wanna keep that acid down in the morning. It's perfect. It's absolutely perfect. You wanna try to stick to a more green banana. I know we've been raised to, oh, let's wait till they're ripe, but actually green bananas are healthier because as that banana sits there and kind of ferments, if you will, it becomes a more sugary, starchy, carby type fruit. When they're more green, they're not as sugary, believe it or not. But I love bananas because they do decrease the inflammation as well, and that's the overall goal here. Get less swollen, recover faster from a workout. So while bananas are close in calories to a bar like this, this is very small compared to a banana. Banana fills you up. You want to hit the foods that are very filling and just low in calorie compared to their mass. You can eat a lot of spinach and not eat a lot of calories. A banana is much bigger than this, again. So these don't fill me up. I don't generally eat these anymore because, well, I could probably eat 10 of these and still not feel full. So you definitely want to try to use these foods as your tools. Get a lot of volume and a lot less calories. You'll feel fuller, you'll feel more satisfied. And at the end of the day, eating a piece of fruit versus eating something like this, you just feel better. And as the months and weeks go by, you definitely feel the difference in your whole body, your skin, your hair, just everything feels better. So use these foods to your advantage. I appreciate you guys watching. I know you want to eat with me and a shop with me video, and I'm going to get that to you. So hit the subscribe button and ring the notification bell so you don't miss those videos. And go back and check on my smoothie video, which I'll link in the description. I think you guys will enjoy that recipe. And that's something that can hold you over in the meantime until we get that next video out. Again, I'm Dad Bod to Bad Dad, and I am signing out.